Hi, my name is Megan from LUMOplay, and I am going to talk a little bit about cameras today and some other sensors that you can potentially use with LUMOplay. So let's start with the cameras that we recommend. This is our most popular camera. This is the Orbbec Astra. It's been out for many years. It's a very solid camera, and it's an IR structured light camera. So it works in a lot of different lighting conditions and will handle things like changing lighting conditions very, very well, as long as there's no direct sunlight or any kind of IR interference. So if you're putting your system near a window, that this might not be the best camera to use, but as long as your system follows our guidelines, this is typically the camera that people choose, both because it works really reliably in most situations and also because it's the least expensive of all of our recommended cameras, coming in at just under $200. One thing that is a downside to this camera is the base that it ships with, which is normally attached here, has a screw hole that is standard in China, but very difficult to find a camera mount for in North America. You can jam a regular sized security camera mount into this thing, but what we've done is we've 3D printed our own mounts for it. And they're very simple. They just slide right on and you can fasten them with a simple zip tie. If you are interested in the STL for this, let us know. We'll post it on our website. But otherwise, the mounts that come with it do work. They're just not ideal if you are installing a lot of them. The second most popular camera is the Intel RealSense D435F. Which is a stereoscopic camera, so it's stereoscopic passive IR. This one is a little bit more affected by IR light, and it's also a little bit harder to get. It doesn't ship all over the world like the Orbbec does, and RealSense is not the most reliable company when it comes to producing their cameras. You'll notice a bunch of RealSense devices on the left here that have either been discontinued or have not received the support necessary for us to reliably offer support for them on LUMOplay. But the 435F still works quite well, and we do still recommend it. And one advantage to this camera is it has a bit of a wider field of view. It doesn't have as long a range as this camera, but both of them work within our recommendations when it comes to an installation. If you are planning to install your camera a little bit closer to the screen, this might be a better option for you. We've added support for some of the newer Orbbec cameras. This is the Gemini 2. And this camera has a very wide field of view. So this is really great for portable systems or systems where the camera is going to be in close proximity to the floor or wall where you're putting in your installation. It's very good for form factor and for price. I think it's about $300. And what's really extra special about it is that wide field of view, but that can also be a bit of a downside. If your camera is too far from your surface, you're going to lose resolution because you're capturing a very large area and you're really just tracking a small part of that, so there's less pixels to track. So a great option for portable systems and systems where your tracking area is in proximity to whatever it is you're tracking. Great for tabletops, sandboxes, things like that. Not so good for long-range tracking. And then this is my personal favorite. This is the upgrade to the Astra. This is the Astra 2. And I am a huge fan of this camera. It's what I am upgrading my system with today. And it's received really great reviews from other customers who've used it. The downside is the price. It's about twice as much as the original Astra. There's a lot of good reasons for that. There's huge improvements in this camera. Like the Astra before it, it is a structured light camera. Similar to the Kinect, Orbbec also has a deal with Microsoft, so a lot of their newer cameras like the larger Femto Mega and some of the Bolt cameras are shipping with a direct connection to the old Kinect SDK, which has now been updated. So if you're in the market for something with really good skeletal tracking, this is a very good camera to choose. Now I'm going to move on to some of the cameras that will work with LUMOplay, but that we do not recommend and why we don't recommend them. So I'll start with this one. This is the RealSense L515. This is a really fast camera. You can really boost the speed on this. And we have used it in custom installations in the past, but it is no longer in production. And as a result, we don't recommend it because we aren't receiving ongoing updates for the drivers. And because it's really only useful for very specific applications, like if you're tracking a very small area at a very high speed. These two are the D4 L515 and the regular D345D. I have to look at it. These camera companies really do need to come up with better names for things, because it would be really nice if we could just call them individual names. So this is the D435 and this is the D515. And what you'll notice about both of these compared to this one is there's a lot more dots on the front, and that's because it has an RGB camera as well as it is an unfiltered IR sensor. And what that means is that if you use any of these cameras with a projection and they're pointed at the projector, they're not going to be able to differentiate. They're going to see everything in the projector. They're not going to be able to differentiate between something moving and the projection. So just stereoscopic depth as a general rule is not quite as good as structured light and will give you a much messier feed. And we do not recommend that you use these cameras with LUMOplay. And the last camera that will still work and that we actually do recommend for a couple of our installations, in particular the photo booth applications where we are doing skeletal tracking, the Xbox Kinect. This is a favorite within the community, but I'm going to show you why I hate it. Compared to all of these other cameras that just have a single USB connection to the computer, this is what you need to power the Kinect. And there's no reason for this, but I think it was developed originally for a console, so in order to plug it into your computer, you need an adapter. This isn't even all the cables that you need. I couldn't find the power cable itself. This is just an adapter that allows you to plug it into your computer. So this is a hassle. It's huge. It generates a lot of heat, and it's not the best camera for any application unless you happen to have one and you want to use it for some reason. It will work with LUMOplay, but again, because it's no longer in production and it's not being supported, we can't support it. And then the last thing that I want to cover in this video is custom sensors that we can support that are not part of our core library. So these are just some examples. There are OEM depth sensors that you can build directly into turnkey systems. We have people that are making projectors, custom projectors with LUMOplay on board, and they're using something like this and embedding it into a projector. And that works really well if you want to do it, but you do need to contact us so that we can test it and make sure that the drivers are up to date. There are also things like, this is a little LiDAR sensor. This is what is in a Roomba. And what this will do is it has a laser in it that spins very quickly. And when you interrupt that laser, it detects it. And so this doesn't produce an image. It's not a camera, but it will tell you if something is in close proximity to it. And it also gives you a very wide area all the way around it. The downside to using something like this in an installation is that you have to build your own hardware. This isn't a plug and play device. This is something that comes with a chip and a board that you have to solder onto another computer. And so while LUMOplay can support stuff like this, and there are some turnkey devices on the market, particularly from companies like Opti2O, that will work with LUMOplay, as a general rule, if you're building something and you're planning to mass produce it, and it makes sense to just track one flat plane with an interruption field, this is a very inexpensive way to do it. But the turnkey cameras that are designed to do interactive projection tracking start at about $2,000. So while we can support them, we don't typically recommend them unless you're building something from scratch yourself. This is an example from a company called Nexmosphere that uses the same LiDAR sensor. So you can see this looks almost exactly the same, but they've also developed their own chip that converts the signal into something that a digital signage platform can understand. So this gets you a little bit closer to something, but again, this is a site-specific, purpose-built sensor. So it's not something that you would use in every single installation, and it's not something that we have apps for that are built straight out of the box, because there just aren't that many people using this type of solution. But these are great for lift and learn applications or for museums where you want a very specific area, say to play some audio or to project some information when somebody performs an action like lifting something up. They're also really, really cool for custom escape room applications, and we can develop LUMOplay apps for them. But again, none of the apps in our library are developed for this because it does still require a lot of hardware customization. And then the last custom sensor that I want to share isn't really that customized. This is an IR touchscreen frame, and this will actually work with LUMOplay apps straight out of the box. But we don't see a lot of people using them yet, largely because touchscreens and having a really good IR frame are interchangeable in terms of cost. And also because these are kind of hard to get. You have to source them from manufacturers and assemble them yourself. And so that's very daunting for a lot of people. But the company that made this one actually makes a really big one. And we're starting to see some companies in Australia, most notably Vision One, who's been a reseller of LUMOplays for quite a long time, come up with some really interesting sports applications where they're tracking a wall for accuracy using one of these frames. So if that's something that interests you, I'll leave Vision One's contact in the description of this video. I'm also going to link to all of the cameras and sensors that I recommended today and directly to the store pages. They aren't affiliate links. We just really like these cameras and want to support them. None of this was sponsored. This is just through 15 years of experience using all kinds of cameras that we made this video, because we do get a lot of questions and people reach out to us and say which one of these cameras is best for our project. And you know, if you take nothing else from this video, the conclusion is that the two Astras that I recommended, the Astra 1 and the Astra 2, are the best cameras that I would recommend for almost every project, unless you have a very specific application like high accuracy sports tracking, or something, you're tracking something very small, or your camera's gonna be very close to the surface, in which case there are other cameras that are really suitable for that. You can always contact us at info@lumoplay.com if you have questions, or leave a comment in the description. Please like, subscribe, ring the notification bell, do anything you can to engage with this video. This is our only form of marketing. So anything that you can do to engage with the video will really help us a lot. Thanks for watching to the end, and I'll see you next Tuesday.